Yeah. my spirit prevails. Do not turn your face away from me, lest I like those who go down into the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, for I put my hope in you and hope of my trust. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way in which I should walk, and lift up my soul to you. Rescue me, O Lord, and prove my enemies as to you that I have left your refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you, my God, your good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Your namesake, O Lord, will you shall bring in me. In your righteousness, you shall bring my soul out of trouble. In your mercy, shall I not destroy my enemies, and you shall destroy all.
Amen. As a hope and foundation, and all.
us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and for the ages of ages.
Thank you.
Christ our God. Have mercy upon us and save us. Διευμόν την Αγίων Πατρονιμών. Κυρίσου Χριστέ ο Θεός. Ελέησον και σώσον ημάς.
Amen.
May the protection of the Holy Trinity be with you always. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We gather at this time, most of us at home who are watching along, to offer our prayers to the Holy Mother of God. And we're offering this service because sure many of you know by now or not that the monks of Mount Athos, that spiritual oasis and beacon, dedicated to the Mother of God, is offering up their prayers. All the monks of Mount Athos offering prayers to the Mother of God, to Saint Haralambos, for their intercessions that this pandemic may be slowed down and may come to an end, that it may stop ravaging the world. And I don't know about all of you, but I absolutely experienced everyone's prayers. And they're still praying right now, because I think their prayers are going to go on for much longer. But we at least join them at this time. And by doing so, we're adding our strength and our heart and all our being to the Mother of God, because she has great intercessory power, because she loves each and every one of us and the world. And one of the hymns definitely spoke to me that I think is very appropriate for our occasion. For those in great sorrow, you are joy. And for the oppressed, the protection. And for the hungry, their food. Comfort unto those estranged, you are a staff of the blind. Visitation of all those sick. And to those held by pain, shelter and a comforting. And to the orphan and aid. Mother of our God in the highest, you are the spotless one. Hasten, save your servants from their sin, we ask of you. And I think that hymn speaks to what we're all going through, the different emotions, the different experiences, for us and for our loved ones and for our world. And we cannot give up hope, and we do not give up hope. And these services that you can do at home are one of the most important ways that we do our part against this pandemic, to draw the spiritual energy and to harness it against this pandemic is what we're here to do. We don't know what will happen in the days or weeks to come, but what we do know, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, is God has given us not a spirit of fear, but of peace, a sound mind, and power, and love. Because, my brothers and sisters, we are aligned with the King of Glory. I find it interesting that the coronavirus, that term corona, has, I think, in some definitions, the definition of a crown, that shape of a crown, which apparently this virus has. But make no mistake about it, there is only one crown, and that is worn by Christ. He is our King. And as long as we're aligned to Him and He to us, we will be victorious. We have nothing to fear. Christ is with us. And let that comfort us. Let that give us strength. And let it give us the resolve to continue to move forward with love and
and determination, being even more dedicated to our faith, even more dedicated in prayer, and even more dedicated to service of our neighbor as best as we can, to be mindful of those elderly and those others who perhaps have no one to get groceries for them, to check in on them. Above all, we can check in on our loved ones, our friends, our neighbors, our fellow church members. This is where, these are the ways we, what we can do. It's our part in responding to this situation, because it's in the most dire moments, my brothers and sisters, I believe, where Christians shine and show what they're made of. And this is what we're made of. We're people of prayer, people of faith, and people who are of service to everyone. God bless you. May God continue to give all of us strength and hope. And no matter what happens, the Lord is with us, and so is His mother. And we are united throughout the world in prayer, which I know has great power. By doing so, by coming together, all together, throughout the world, and at this time with the monks of Mount Athos, I know the prayers are even more powerful. So thank you for adding your prayers to the worldwide prayer that's going on. God bless you, and may our Lord be with all of you. Amen.